Hey guys, in this lesson we would understand how to factor polynomials completely. Now, what is meant by factoring polynomials is factoring is a technique to change standard form of a polynomial to factored form. Now, why do we need to change a standard form of polynomial to a factored form? Is because we can use the factored form easily to graph polynomial, and graphing polynomials we have already covered up in the previous unit. Also, once we get the factored form, then we can solve polynomials as well. Solving means finding the value of the variable. If we try to graph the standard form of polynomial directly, or if we try to solve the standard form of polynomial, it would not be possible. Therefore, the best way is to change the standard form of polynomial to a factored form and do whatever is required in the question. The question wants us to graph the polynomial, then we can use the factored form to graph it. Or if the question wants us to solve the polynomial, then we can use the factored form to solve it as well. In this lesson, we would cover up how to change the standard form of polynomial to factored form, as this change step is called factoring. Now, the question wants us to factor this polynomial x cubed minus 5x squared minus 2x plus 24 completely. Just a reminder, factored form means bracket bracket form, and if the degree is 3, the number of factors that we would be able to figure out would be 3 factors. Similarly, if the degree is 2, we are able to get 2 factors. And if the degree is 4, we are able to get 4 factors. Now, what are the steps to factor a given polynomial completely? Step number 1 is we always take the constant of the polynomial. So here the constant is the value that has no variable attached to it, and divide the constant by the leading coefficient. Leading coefficient is 1 in this case. So for this particular example, we will divide 24 with 1 and we get back 24 itself. Second step is to find the factors of the value that we have obtained in step number 1. In this example, the value that we have obtained is 24. So we would write on all the factors of 24. When we say all the factors, it has to be all the integer factors, both plus and the minus values. So we know it's going to be plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, plus minus 4, plus minus 6, plus minus 8, plus minus 12, plus minus 24. So these are all the factors of 24. Step number 3 is use the factors obtained in step number 2 one by one to find out which factor gives us an f of a value of 0. Now, what does this step mean? Is if we consider this original function as fx, this is going to be our fx function. We are going to use the factors plus minus 1, plus minus 2, and so on as an a value to sub in place of x in this function to find out which of these factors would give us an f of x of 0. Let's rewrite the function here. The function that we are given is x cubed minus 5x squared minus 2x plus 24. Now we would be using the first factor of step 2, and that is plus 1, and sub in place of x in the fx equation. When we put this on the calculator, the value that we get is 18. So 1 is not the factor of this polynomial. The reason we are doing is to figure out which of these numbers is going to be the factor of the entire polynomial. That's why we are looking for the value of f of a equal to 0. Since here f of 1 is not equal to 0, so 1 is not the factor of the entire polynomial. Let's check f of negative 1. When we put all of this on the calculator, we get the value of 20. Therefore, minus 1 is also not the factor of the entire polynomial. Next, we try f of 2. We put this on the calculator and then we get a value of 8. Since it's not a 0 again, this is not a value that we are looking for. Let's try f of negative 2. When we sub in negative 2 in the polynomial, the remainder or the value that we get is a 0. So this is the desired a value that we are looking for, because f of negative 2 gives us a 0. Once we get the required value of a, we can proceed to step number 4, and that is use the a value that gives f of a equal to 0 to write the divisor, or specifically in this case, now this divisor is going to be called a factor of the polynomial, and the polynomial is represented with fx. In this example, we have got a as a negative 2. We know if a is equal to negative 2, then x plus 2 should be the factor of fx. We always put this number back with x with the opposite sign, and this factor is one of the factors of the three factors that we're looking for this polynomial. So this first bracket has got its answer, and that is x plus 2. Now to get the values for the rest of the two brackets, what we would do is the next step. So step number 5 is use the factor obtained in step number 4 to find the other factors with the help of long or synthetic division. So for this particular question where we've got fx as x cubed minus 5x squared minus 2x plus 24, we will be dividing this polynomial with the first factor x plus 2 that is obtained using factor theorem. Now we can either use long division or synthetic division, because this factor or this divisor is a linear polynomial. As synthetic division is easier and faster, so we would be preferring to do synthetic division in this case. We use this x plus 2 to solve for x, so x is negative 2. We put negative 2 outside, take the coefficients, 1 minus 5 minus 2, 24. Make sure all the variable powers are there, so 3, 2, 1, 0. So we do not have to put in any 0 in there. Now first step is to bring the first number down as is. Negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. When we add it, we get a negative 7. Negative 2 times negative 7 is a 14. When we add it, we get a 12. Negative 2 times 12 is a negative 24. And we know that the remainder has to be 0 because this is the factor of this polynomial. So this gives us the quotient, and the quotient is 1x squared minus 7x plus 12. We know from the previous lessons that when the remainder is 0, then both the quotient as well as the divisor are called the factors of the polynomial. So both x plus 2 and x squared minus 7x plus 12 are the factors of this polynomial. So let's write down step number 6, that is rewrite the polynomial. We have polynomial as fx in the form of its factors, as our polynomial was x cubed minus 5x squared minus 2x plus 24. We can write this down as the product of its factors. The first factor is x plus 2 times second factor is x squared minus 7x plus 12. This is the divisor, this is the quotient, and we are writing it as a product because the rule says divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder should give us the dividend. And in this case, since the remainder is 0, so the dividend is just left to be equal to the product of divisor and quotient. Step 7 is to factorize the quotient that we obtained in step 5 if possible. Now the quotient that we obtained is x squared minus 7x plus 12. We know this is a trinomial, so we can find out the sum of negative 7 and product of 12. And the numbers that we use is negative 3 and negative 4. Therefore, this can be written as x minus 3, x minus 4. Step number 8 is to write the polynomial in final factored form. If this factoring was not possible, then this would have been the final factored form. Since this factoring is possible, therefore, the final factored form of the standard form x cubed minus 5x squared minus 2x plus 24 is x plus 2, x minus 3, x minus 4. So now this fx that was in standard form has been converted to the new fx that is in factored form. This is how we use the combination of factor theorem as well as synthetic division to find out the factors of the standard form of a polynomial. The same steps would be used if the polynomial had degree 4, It's just that if it is degree 4, then we would have to repeat all of these steps 2 times. There is a shortcut to factoring when there comes specific types of polynomials, and those are the polynomials that are present in the form of sum or difference of cubes. Let's take that as an example as well. Let's say we are given a polynomial x cubed minus 64. We know x cubed can be written as cube of x, and we know 64 can be written as a cube of 4. So when a polynomial is written as a difference of cubes, then we can apply a straight factoring formula, and that formula is a cube minus b cube would be equal to a minus b a square plus ab plus b square. So if a question can be written in this form, its factors are a minus b a square plus ab plus b square. So for this particular example, we do not have to do all the steps that we have covered up prior to this example to factor this question. All we have to do is just use this formula. So this is a cube minus b cube can be written as a minus b, because the a value is x and the b value is 4. So we write down x minus 4. In another bracket, we would have x square plus x times 4 is 4x plus 4 times 4 or 4 square is 16. So this is the factored form of this standard form of question. We can only use the formula if the question is given to us as a difference of cubes. Let's take up another example where we are given the question in the form of sum of cubes. Let's say we are given 8x cubed plus 27. Now 8x cubed can be written as 2x whole cube, and 27 can be written as a cube of 3. So whenever a question can be written as sum of cubes, its factored form is a plus b a square minus ab plus b square. Since this is an a here and this is a b here, we can complete the factoring of this polynomial using the formula, and that is 2x plus 3 in the first bracket, and the second bracket would be 2x square, because the entire a has to be squared and a is 2x in this case, minus 2x times 3 because it's a times b plus b square, b is 3, so it would be 3 square. And we can write on the final answer in the next step, that is 2x plus 3 is the first factor, 2x whole square is 4x square minus 6x plus 9. And this is how we can change a cubic polynomial given as the sum of cubes using the formula to factored form, without using factor theorem and synthetic division.